Apologies. Why and how you say, why you should say sorry? When was the last time you feel guilty for something you did? Maybe you made a mistake that hurt someone, or maybe you choose to do the wrong things out of anger or selfishness. Either way, the simplest words I'm sorry can help you and others persons feel better. It isn't always easy to admit your mistakes. You did wrong. In the short terms, it can be painful, but you can learn from your mistakes without admitting them. Apologies is a key part of personal growth. Apologies is also important for relationship. Refusing apologies can break team apart and friendships and create tension within families. But when you apologize, the other person knows that you understand their feelings. It helps to heal hurts. You might fear that apologies makes you look weird. But actually, it shows that you have strength to put the other person before yourself. In fact, after apologies, you might become closer to your friends than before. But even after you decided to apologize, you might not be sure how to do it. Here are some tips. Don't put off your apologies. Set your stories as soon as you release the suit. Apologies in person, if possible. Shows that you feel remorse and understand how the other person feel. For example, you could say, I'm sorry that I was late for our meetings. I should have kept track of the time better. Or I'm sorry that I yelled at you. I feel terrible embarrassing you like that. Don't make excuse or implies that your presence is problem. So instead of saying I'm sorry you feel upset about what I said, says I'm sorry for my hurt comment. Committed to changing your behavior. Don't keep doing what your apologies for. If you do, the other person might doubt that you truly apologize. Apologies can be hard, but they are necessary for a healthy relationship.
Huh?